time also. And I thank you very much, Chairman of the Committee, ladies and gentlemen here at the head table. I almost feel like we all should go back to Sacramento. Coming and a reunion with my fellow members of the Commonwealth, all wrapped up in one. And I could take a challenge for the 80s. With the help of your vision, courage, and leadership, we'll create this union so that we could become a victim nation. We're not sons and daughters. More is in question than just prosperity. Ultimately, peace and freedom are at stake. The United States took the lead after World War II in creating an internet, and the greater the impetus for world peace. Deterioration. Too many otherwise free nations adopted policies of government intervention in the marketplace. Many doesn't renew our spirits. Now, I'm not going to minimize the problems that we face or the long, tough road that we must travel to solve them. We began importing more than we were exporting. Since 1976, imports have exceeded exports every year. And our trade deficit greatly increased the value of the dollar and made our goods, as a result, less competitive. High interest rates, 5 years, were in export-related industries. And yet 90% of American manufacturers do not export at all. Now, many of these are small and medium-sized firms. Our administration has a positive market access. This begins at home. Our economic reforms are based on time-tested principles. Spending and monetary restraint. We must plug the holes in the boat of open markets and free trade and set sail to get that kind of success story and multiply it by a million. We can do it. Albert Einstein told us.
Anniversary. President. Thank you.